The potential benefits of exercise for the elderly and people with disabilities are substantial, and the potential for lowering healthcare costs are considerable. Despite this, only a small percentage of these populations engage in the recommended amounts of exercise. One of the problems is lack of access to community-based exercise programs for these populations. In this context, the experience of a program in Tuscany, Italy, should be instructive. The Italian Adaptive Physical Activity Program, or APA, began as an initiative of Local Health Authority 11 in Tuscany, Italy, under the direction of Dr. Francesco Benvenuti, through a joint Memorandum of Understanding for research collaborations between the U.S. National Institutes of Health and its Italian counterpart, the ISS. A clinical trial was undertaken to determine the efficacy of APA for people with chronic stroke.
Well, there is a huge amount of evidence in the published literature that exercise is fundamental for health. It's fundamental for health to maintain health for the primary prevention of diseases. But there is also evidence that if it's important for healthy people to stay healthy, is even more important for people with chronic diseases to prevent the evolution of the disease and the occurrence of disability.
APA was determined safe and effective in improving walking speed, balance, and quality of life. A research trial recently completed in another region of Italy confirms the effectiveness of an enhanced APA with an educational intervention in improving outcomes for patients with stroke following discharge from rehabilitation. A different APA protocol has been popular with people suffering from back pain. The success of this exercise program led to the establishment of APA as a cornerstone of health policy in Tuscany for the prevention and management of chronic disease. Recently, the Tuscan Regional Health Authority established benchmarks for APA enrollment for all of the 12 health authorities in Tuscany and incorporated these benchmarks into performance plans for the senior executive managers of the health authorities. As of June 2013, Tuscany had a total of approximately 20,000 participants enrolled in 1,300 APA classes, or 2.4% of the population, 65 and above. The success of the Tuscany APA experience led the Italian Ministry of Health to include APA within the national guidelines for the Organization of Rehabilitation Services. Can the APA program be translated into a U.S. context? A recent study suggests it can. The Better Balance program, piloted by the Howard County, Maryland Office on Aging with funding from the United States Department of Veterans Affairs, uses the APA exercise protocol in a community exercise program for people with stroke, Parkinson's disease, and frailty. Classes meet three times a week for an hour in local senior centers.
This program has met an important need in the community. Participants remain enthusiastic, and we have consistently had a waiting list for the classes.
I had problems because the stroke affected my right side, so I had problems with balancing. And it has been good for me, and I can now turn to the right without falling down.
Sometimes I do bring my kids here, so it's encouragement to me too, because this type of sickness needs encouragement to do all this.
We are grateful to the Department of Veterans Affairs for funding this study and certainly hope to participate in upcoming studies that, like this one, translate empirical evidence into just very practical, community-friendly prevention programs for seniors.
There are now two independent research studies from Italy supporting the use of APA for chronic stroke patients, and another study supporting a different APA protocol for back pain in the frail elderly. The research challenges before us are to design optimal exercise regimens for specific populations. We also need to explore the use of new technologies to improve access to exercise and enhance participation. Through technology, we may be able to provide customized feedback to patients in their homes. The challenge for this future endeavor is to use technology as an enabling factor for disabled populations. In the meantime, there is no doubt that exercise is healthy for everyone and especially important for people with disabilities such as stroke, Parkinson's disease, and the frail elderly. Here in the U.S., we have to find new ways to make exercise accessible and affordable for these populations. Certainly, the roles of political, medical, and local leadership have been crucial to the development and implementation of APA in Italy. The Affordable Care Act may provide additional opportunities and incentives to engage patients in sustained exercise in the United States. I want to thank the research teams in Italy and in the United States and our community partners that are collaborating to expand the research on APA and to reduce the barriers to access in the community for these populations. Thank you.